Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Now we have begun the new Tamil month of Purattasi, which begins from 17th September till 17th October. Now, in this month, the Saturdays are very auspicious for offering our prayers to Bhagwan Vishnu. And in some families, they make particular items and offer it as part of their prayers to Bhagwan Vishnu. So some people have a full festival menu. But the main item is this ellu saru. Ellu is black tail. So we make a variety rice using black tail. Sometimes we make three types of variety rice, and then sakra pongal, that is the sweet pongal as a sweet dish, and also vadai made with pepper, black pepper. So, and also a sundal made with black chana, or you can even use the white chana also. These Saturdays are generally the first, third, or sometimes if there is a fifth Saturday, on these Saturdays only we do this prasadam. The menu might vary from family to family, as I told you. So 19th was the first Saturday, that is over. Now the coming Saturday, which is the 26th of September, will be the second Saturday. So we offer it only on first and third Saturdays. So 3rd October is the third Saturday. I am showing this ahead of time so you can also offer your prayers to Bhagwan Vishnu. And it is also believed that it is these Saturdays are special for Shani Bhagwan too. And Shani Bhagwan, when you pray to him on these the Saturdays of this month, he removes all the negativity from your life and you are endowed with good health, happiness and auspicious occasions in your life. First we'll get ready by keeping the rice and dal together for the sweet pongal or sakra pongal. Here I have cut plain rice for the curd rice and the ellu rice, that is the black sesame, thin sesame for those who don't know, sesame rice. And in this one I am going to place the black chana. See, actually I forgot to soak it overnight, so this morning I used my little trick of putting it in hot water and keeping it in a hot case or casserole. So this, now it is soaked well and I can pressure cook it on. For the sweet pongal, I have taken 3/4 cup of rice and 1/4 cup of this moong dal, yellow moong dal. We lightly roast it and then wash it along with the rice. See, the moong dal is lightly roasted. I just wash this rice and dal and also the plain rice and bring it back. This is rice and dal for the sakra pongal. So for 3/4 cup of rice, I have taken nearly 3 cups of water. And this is the rice for the variety rice, sesame rice as well as curd rice. And on top of, and for this I have kept less water, only 2 cups of water, because we don't want the rice to be soft and mushy. Whereas for the sakra pongal, we need very soft rice, it has to be mashed well. And this sundal I have kept here, that is the soaked chana. And I am just going to add a little bit of salt to this. Place this in your pressure cooker and cook it for 2 whistles. Before starting the video, I had already soaked 1 cup of urad dal for 1 hour and ground it into a thick batter for making vadai and kept ready. So while the rice is getting cooked, we will make the powder for this sesame rice or ellu saru. For that, I have taken here 2 tablespoons of black tail or sesame seeds, and we will also require about 3 dry red chilies and some urad dal to dry roast. So first I can put the dry red chilies, and also we will take about 3 teaspoons of urad dal, roast them together. See, the dal has roasted well and also the chili. Now I am adding 2 tablespoons of this sesame seeds. I will roast it also along with this. See, the sesame seeds will start popping up like that. You can switch it off. It cools down to room temperature. We'll grind all these ingredients into a powder in our mixer jar. So our cooker is done. While I'm waiting for it to cool down, we can make the vadais. And here's the urad dal batter. And to this, we are going to add whole black pepper. I'm taking 1 teaspoon. You can either add it as it is or just lightly crush it. That's it. Add it to this batter. Also, add some fresh curry leaves to it. And a little bit of grated ginger. I kept oil for heating. Mix the batter very well like this. We have to also add the required salt for this. Now, mix it well. Wet your hands. Take out small or lemon sized portions of the dough. And we'll shape the vadais. Somebody had asked me, madam, how do we avoid the vadais getting oily? The trick is not to add too much water while grinding. If you add too much water while grinding, it will absorb more oil on frying. So always grind with very little water. One more thing, as I am frying the vadais, Krishnaveni from Vizag, you wanted me to say a hi to you. So hi Krishnaveni. And regarding this live session which we had recently, I want to thank all of you for the overwhelming response and your participation. And at the same time, I want to say, please don't mind if I didn't mention some of your names during the chat or the live YouTube. See, it was the very first time for me in live streaming. So I was also a little bit apprehensive whether everything would go well. I saw many people. I saw Meena Kumari, I saw Arati, and a couple of others too on the chat, and your many more names kept coming up. So I'm sure next time it will be much better. Anyhow, we had a very great response, and I hope most of your questions have been answered. And for others too, all your comments will be answered either by me or by Meena. See, now they've been fried to a lovely golden red color on both the sides. Carefully drain it out from the oil, and similarly make the vadais from the remaining batter also. I have opened the cooker. This is for the sakra pongal, this is for the sesame rice, yellow sadam and curd rice, and this for the sundar. We'll keep this aside for now. Here I have taken jaggery for the sakra pongal, that is the sweet pongal, adding a little water just to dissolve it. Just mash this rice a little bit, either with a masher or with the back of a spoon also you can do, and keep it ready. When the syrup is boiling well and the jaggery has also dissolved, see, like this. If required, you filter it, but if you feel your jaggery is quite clean, then you can directly add this cooked rice and dal to it. Mix it very well together, the jaggery syrup and this cooked rice and dal, and allow it to just boil for a couple of minutes. See, when you make this, always add the cooked rice to the syrup. Then you can control the quantity of rice. If you add the syrup to the rice and your syrup becomes less, you will have to again make more syrup. It will become difficult. So this way it is better. Here I have kept some ghee for heating, and we'll add some cashew and raisins and add it to the sakra pongal. Here I have some of my badam drink powder, which has got saffron, cardamom, everything. It will add a good flavor, but you can just add some powdered cardamom, that is fine. And I am going to mix this. Cashew nuts in ghee till they are nice and golden. Just add in the raisins, fry them also. Pour this on top of the sakra pongal. Beautiful. lovely sakra pongal ready to be offered to Bhagwan. Now with the remaining plain rice, I have taken half the quantity into another bowl and spread it out. This remaining portion I'll use for curd rice. For this we are making the til rice or elli sadam, sesame, black sesame rice. This is the powder which we had made. So add this powder to this rice. Add some salt to it. This til oil, that is sesame oil or gingery oil, whichever way you call it. Add a teaspoon of that to the rice. And also I am going to add some til oil for tempering. That will bring out the authentic flavor of this elli sadam. Now add some mustard seeds, urad dal, one dry red chilli, a little bit of hing, that is asafoetida, and finally some fresh curry leaves. Pour it on top of this elli sadam. Then we can mix it all well together so that the sesame powder, salt and the rice get very well blended together. The remaining plain rice I am dividing for the lemon rice and curd rice. So here we will take some of it for the lemon rice. Add a teaspoon of til oil to this, or any other cooking oil, you use groundnut or sunflower oil also, it's okay. Add some salt, also adding a pinch of turmeric powder to this. If you add the hot oil to it, it will get a lovely color. Mustard seeds, urad dal, chana dal, a few, a little bit of grated ginger, some green chilies, and one dry red chili. Now we will pour this on top of the turmeric. So don't worry, you will not get raw smell of turmeric. It will taste quite good in fact. Now mix everything well together. Also adding a few curry leaves. This is juice of lemon. You add as per your taste. Quantities of each type of rice you can make according to your preference. Here at home we all enjoy eating this elli sadam, so I made this of more quantity and lesser of lemon rice. Either you can have all equal quantities, totally left to you. Next for sundar, just heat some oil, about 2 teaspoons of oil. We'll add some mustard seeds, urad dal, one dry red chilli, a little bit of hing, curry leaves, adding this boiled chana, mix it well. Remember we added a little bit of salt in the beginning while cooking the chana. So I am just going to add very little more. Just stir fry it till the water evaporates, just for a couple of minutes, and add some grated coconut to it. Fresh grated coconut. Mix it well. our channa sundal is also ready. Next, with the remaining plain rice, we are going to make curd rice. So we had left it nice and separate grains for the lemon rice and the sesame rice. For this, we just lightly mash it with the back of a spoon like this. Add some salt to it. I'm adding a little bit of grated ginger also to this. Mix it well. Here I have some fresh curd. I'm adding a little bit extra curd because it will tend to take in all the curd. So it tastes good, but it is a bit flowing consistency and not very thick. Tempering the curd rice, again take some oil in a pan. Add some mustard seeds, chopped green chilies, and a few curry leaves. If you like, you can add urandal also, but I prefer not to add today. So I am just adding mustard, green chilies, and curry leaves we have added to the tempering. On top of this, I am just going to add a small pinch of hing. Our tasty curd rice is also ready. As you can see, all our dishes are ready to offer the naivedyam to Sri Venkateshwara or Balaji Swami. And see, we make about 11 or 21 vadais and make a mala of it and offer it to Bhagwan. And here we have all this sakara pongal, vadai, sundal, ellisadam, lemon rice and curd rice. And of course, as usual for any puja, we light the lamp, draw rangoli, decorate with flowers. And here I have coconut, betel leaf, betel nut and some fruits to offer. So we pray to Bhagwan and offer all these naivedyam items and then accept the prasadam. Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen. We'll meet again in another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Thank you.